Hello everyone, hope you all are fine. So today we are going to discuss about A House is Not a Home, written by Zan Gorieso. So this story reflects the challenges of being a teenager and the problems of growing up. How does the author overcome his problem? We'll come to know through this story. So let's proceed. This story highlights the thin difference between a house and a home. While a house is a building where people live, a home is a place where a family lives together, sharing the unique bond of love and oneness. The narrator's house gets destroyed by fire and he gets a new house. Then he realizes that his home is the one built by the love and affection of his family and loved ones. Love and affection of one's family is precious. So let us start the story. Jan, the author, lives with his mom, as he had already lost his father. Now, after passing junior high school, the author joined a high school. It was a big school. The author felt awkward during his first year of high school. He missed his old school badly. He often went to meet his old teachers. They encouraged him to get involved in school activities. One Sunday afternoon, not long after he had started high school, he was sitting at home doing his homework. His little cat was sitting on the table. Tai smelled something strange. Then he noticed smoke pouring in through the seams of the ceiling. Soon, the whole room was engulfed in flames. The author and his mother came out of the room. The author ran to neighbors to call the fire brigade. He saw and back to the house. She came out after some time holding a metal box containing important documents. Dropping the box in the lawn, she ran back into the house. The author was about to run after her mother, but a fireman stopped him forcibly. The other fireman rushed in to save the mother. They could bring her safe out of the house. After 5 hours, the fire was finally out. The house was completely burned down. Now, the author realized that his cat was found nowhere. He broke down in tears and cried and cried. He wanted to go inside the house, but the fireman did not let him go inside that night. The author and his mother went to the author's grandparents' house to spend the night. The next day, it was Monday. And the author was to go to school. He was wearing school uniform, but he had no shoes. He borrowed tennis shoes from his aunt. His school bag had burnt in fire. He thought that everything had been finished for him. He walked around the school like a zombie. Everything felt surreal and was not sure what was going to happen. He was feeling insecure. When he walked through what used to be his house after school that day, he was shocked to see how much damage there was. There was no time to grieve. His mother rushed him out of the house. They borrowed money from the author's grandparents. They rented an apartment nearby. When the debris of their burned house was being cleared off, the author came there daily, hoping that his cat was somewhere to be found. The news of this fire tragedy spread in the school. The next day at school, the people were acting even more strange than usual. They had taken up a collection and had bought him school supplies, notebooks, and all kinds of different clothes. They were introducing themselves to the author very warmly. The author made friends that day. A month later of the fire tragedy, their house was being rebuilt. The author's friends were with him. A kind lady came with the author's cat and gave it to him. It brought a new life for the author. So we learned from the story that any kind of hardship, problems, or crucial situations can be overcome by anybody with the help and support of friends and